To begin to make the wind spinner, I have taken three pieces of Rhenia foil out of my package. I have, you can see the three different pieces here, and they are the Starstruck colors. And so let me give you the appropriate names. It is lavender, turquoise, and jade. And this is Starstruck, so it's the same color on both sides, but you could definitely do the other version that has the gold on one side. And I have put it into my page trimmer here, and I'm going to cut it to be a strip of about a quarter of an inch. Now this might just be a hair bigger, but I'm just cutting all three of them down to size, and then I'll move my trimmer out of the way. And then I'm going to take those and actually cut them in half. So if you have a package of 6-inch, that would be perfect for this project. So I'm just going to take a pair of scissors here and cut these down. Okay. So now we have all of the strips. And the next thing that you will need, let's see, how many do I have here? I've got two of each, so I'm going to do that one more time, just so I have, I want to have a little bit more than just the six. So in the end, I will end up having 12 altogether. And then after this, you can decide whether or not you want to put them together in a pattern of color or just random to make your wind spinner. So I'm just going to open these up here to make sure I've got them all. So I think I'm going to go with a pattern that looks like this. So there are my strips that I'm going to use for the spinner. All right. The next thing you're going to need are two brads, and I used color coordinating, but you could use any kind of brad that you'd like. And so I'm just going to take two out of the package just to have it ready to go when I need it in my hand. And these are from American Craft, if you're interested in this brand. So when you take your brad out, you can see that it's a little bit open. And what we want to do is pinch those two together. Even if we have to go at an angle, we want them to be as close together as possible. So hopefully that makes sense there. All right. So we're going to use it kind of like a needle with our paper strips. So to begin, I'm just going to take my stack of paper and start poking through. Now you can do up to three at a time, and it's really not that hard to push through. So I just, you can see here, I've got three, and I just line them up, and I'm going to take my brad and push it through all three. And I said that it wasn't that hard, but there we go. Okay, so you can see how close to the edge here I'm getting. Okay, about 1/8 of an inch in the total brad, maybe a little bit more than 1/8 of an inch. All right, so I'm going to get my next three ready to go. That was a bit of a push to get through there. If you have a needle standing by, you can definitely poke a needle through your foil first to get a hole started. And then use your brad to go further through the paper. Okay, and if it bends a little bit as you're doing it, that's no problem. Just straighten it out after you get it in place. Okay, so we've got two more to go through, two more stacks to go through. And I'm going to do that pin technique again, just because that was, it made it just a little bit easier. And you can see here that my paper is bending, and I'm okay with that. Because Rinia foil paper is obviously foil, you can bend it back into place. Okay? And so here are my last three that I'm going to stack up together. And one more time, take my little pin and go through there. Make sure I'm not going to poke myself. Just be careful. And then stick the brad all the way through. Now I have all the stacks together and on the brad. Now I want to fold that down tight so that it holds in place. Okay, so it looks like that. The next thing I want to do is to fan this out. All right, and I'm actually going to fan it out into a full circle if I can. Something similar to that. Okay, then we're going to take our other brad and do the same trick with it again. Pinch it or bend it just a little bit so they're closer together, like that. And as I put it through, you'll see that I actually pinch it, so it's more like one piece going through. All right, now I'm going to take this whole piece, flip it over. And here you can see that this is my bottom piece here. And then the next one is this one. So you want to follow it around in the way that you made it, okay? So we're going to take it up and flip it over so it's like a circle. All right? And before I put the brad through it, I'm going to flip this over one time. Okay? So it has a little twist in the paper, and then I'm going to stick the brad through it. All right, and you're going to do that to every single piece. Now it may get a little wonky, that's okay. Well, because it's foiled paper, we can adjust it once we're done. So we bring it up, flip it over, make sure you're flipping it in the same direction each time, and then set it onto your brad. So bring it up, flip it over. You can see I'm flipping mine to the left, and then stick it through the brad. Once you have all the pieces with the brad going through it, you're going to press it tight just like you did on the bottom one. Okay, so I'm reaching into the circle. And you can see that this isn't a perfect shape right now. And I have some pieces that have gotten bent a little bit out of shape. And so I just need to straighten those guys out a little bit. Okay, and then just adjust everything. So you've got, now remember this is paper, so you want to gently move things around until you get it how you want it. Now you can also push down on the piece and flatten out the top pieces until you get the shape that you desire. Okay, so that is not looking too bad to me. And so at this point, I am just going to move on from here because I can play with this and fiddle with it even more. But I definitely want to get to the next step, which will be to decorate it. And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to add a string to the top piece here so that I can hang it. And then I'm also going to add some decorative beads to the bottom, and that will give it a little bit of weight and also another little touch, design look to it. So, like I said, I could sit here and play with this for a long time to get it kind of the way I want it and line up the centers with the bottom. Okay, but as you're kind of see here, the twist in the paper is what catches the wind and will make it spin. Okay, so I just have some black thread here, and that's what I'm going to use. And so I'm just going to pull a piece off long enough, grab my scissors. Okay, so I have cut a long piece of thread, and what I'm going to do is find the middle of it and wrap it around that brad that I'm considering the top. And then I'm going to take each one and wrap it to the other side. Okay, so I have a thread coming out kind of either side of the brad. And then I am just going to pull this string out and tie a knot in the end. All right, and you can see that I'm off balance here with my tails, so I'm just gonna even those out and get rid of the scrap. Okay, so now this has a string that it can hang from, like so. All right, but I'm not done yet. I want to turn it over, and on this brad here, I'll try to center that. And like I said, you can continue to play with this thing until you get it the way you want it to look, but it will work no matter what shape you end up making yours. All right, so then I'm going to take some beads that coordinate in color. And I'm going to take, I think I'm going to do, how about a blue one, and I'm going to go the other direction. I'm going to take a little blue one and a green one, and that you can see our coordinating colors. All right, I'll set that aside and bring these two pieces in here. So what I'm going to do is actually go through this one, loop through this one, come back through the green one, and then tie it onto here. All right, so same black thread. I can always cut off the excess. And the holes on these glass beads that I'm using are quite large. I don't need a needle. I can just push the thread right through the bead. So in through the green one, in through the blue one. That's the blue one's going to be kind of like the anchor. Pick up the green one again. Hold on to your string so you don't pull it through. All right, and then go back through the green one. Right. So it's a dangle that looks like that. All right. So now I'm just going to pull on my strings here to kind of even them up a little bit. Not that I need a lot, but I just want to even them up a little bit. And then I'm going to hang this from this piece right here. So I want to give it like maybe just a finger length. I mean, you can make yours as long as you want. Remember, you're working with paper, so you don't want to add a lot of weight to it. But I'm going to take that, I'm just going to wrap it around. Take both strands and wrap them around. And then I'm going to take the bead end, if I can grab it, and the thread end, and use those to tie a knot. And I think it just came undone, so I'm going to do it one more time. Of course, whenever you do something delicate on camera, it always wants to give you fits, doesn't it? So there we go. All right, I'm gonna have to give it a tie and off to the side. And you can see that my messing with that opened a space up here. So I just need to straighten things out again. All right, and so there, let's see, mine's a little lopsided, so I kind of want to pull out on this side here to flatten it out a little bit, see if I can get that to be more balanced. All right, so now, if you can see, if I can get it under the camera enough, and if I blow onto it, let me get my fingers out of the way. There it is, and I'll show you. Here's the first one that I made, and you can see that the strips are a little bit thinner on this one, and you can see that the shape is a little bit different from the side, but they're the similar, and you could, if you wanted to, make multiples of them. And instead of, you know, hanging them separately, you could hang, instead of the bead at the bottom, you could hang them like so, so that you would have a much taller spinner. You could have two on one strand, or three or four, or whatever. And that doesn't show up very well as I'm trying to hold them up. It looks great to me, but I know you're not seeing it correctly on the camera. So, just to show you what these look like. Okay, so there's the bottom. Excuse me, that's the bottom, and this one, the little bead went inside. So let me pull it out. There we go. Alright, so you can see beads are a little bit different on each one, length's a little bit different on each one, colors are similar, and there's the tops, and then, oh, that one lost its bead, but if I hold them up, and I blow on them, you can see them spin.